Thanks for joining us. I'm Alexis Rogers. In just about an hour and a half, the man accused in the murder of a Loring Park grocery store clerk is expected to appear in court. Taylor Schultz is charged with murdering 66-year-old Robert Skaft while he was working at the store on Friday. A criminal complaint says that he killed him with a golf club. Schultz, who lived across the street from the store, was arrested after nearly 6-hour standoff. People who knew Skaft tell us they were devastated.
Gentle soul, giving soul, like cared about people, cared about life, cared about art, cared about gardening, cared about the world.
Schultz is being charged with second-degree murder. We do know he was committed for mental health treatment in 2021. Two people linked to a deadly St. Paul shooting have been booked in jail on suspicion of murder. As we've reported, police found a man with gunshot wounds on the porch of a home on Inglewood Avenue yesterday morning. They say two people had called 911 saying a man that they knew had intruded around 2 a.m. yesterday. A man on that call said he fired multiple shots at him. Now police say the two people from the home refused to answer questions and were booked in Ramsey County Jail. An update to this backup in the eastbound lanes of I-94 late last night. Police tell us that eight people who were protesting in the Lowry Tunnel were arrested. Eight vehicles and three trailers were also towed from the scene. At one point, the backup reached from the tunnel back to Plymouth Avenue. In a statement, the state patrol says that it supports everyone's right to exercise their rights, First Amendment rights, but the freeway is not a good place to do it. Well, turning to our weather now, it's feeling pretty chilly out there today, but we are once again looking ahead to a warm up, John.
Yeah, well, it's definitely cool. I mean, I can feel it. The wind's out here. It looks nice with the sunshine. It's biting a little bit. Temperatures hanging out in the 20s today. 27 degrees. West winds right now 9 miles per hour, making it feel like 18. Teens out there today. Very dry Canadian air rolling in here with that northwest wind. These are actual temperatures. Thief River Falls 12. Bemidji's at 16. We're actually developing some ice. They might, you know, even despite the warmth, could probably get out on the ice later on this week up in northern Minnesota if we could just get another night or two of some cold air. There's the northwest winds. We've got them pretty strong today, 10 to 20. We are seeing gusts here in the cities at around 20, 25 miles per hour. But these are current wind chills. Feels like 3 below in Thief River Falls. 1 in Bemidji, 18 here in the cities. I think we'll maybe bounce to 28 at around 3 o'clock, 1 degree, and then we'll coast down to 22. One more cool night tonight, and then we're going to talk about those 40s moving in here in your long-range forecast. So it's going to warm back up.
You said 40s, my ears perked up.
You're like, yeah, ringing.
There we go. Yeah. John, thank you. We're taking a live look now at the nation's capital, where today Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky is meeting with lawmakers. In his third trip to the nation's capital, Zelensky will talk with President Biden and House Speaker Mike Johnson. If he can convince them to pass a national security package, it would provide billions in aid to Ukraine. The Federal Reserve is also meeting today for the last time this year. Investors are hoping it will avoid raising interest rates. Wall Street experts say the Fed is expected to keep interest rates unchanged between 5.25 and 5.5%. A decision is expected tomorrow afternoon. This year, interest rates have been raised 11 times to fight inflation. Next year, we could see rates come down as early as June. Well, today marks just less than 2 weeks away until Christmas, but right now the Postal Service is under investigation linked to delays. Here's where the concerns come from.
I'm Gordon Severson. The United States Postal Service is auditing 4 locations here in the Twin Cities after customer complaints and formal requests by elected officials. Congresswoman Angie Craig's office says they're hearing from constituents who are getting their mail once every 3 to 5 days. Senators Tina Smith and Amy Klobuchar are also hearing complaints from northern Minnesota, including Bemidji, where workers there are reporting a severe staffing shortages. They're calling on the Postmaster General to fix these issues, not just here during the busy holiday season, but also moving forward so Minnesotans can count on the mail arriving on time.
Within the next 6 hours, the Minneapolis School District could officially have a new superintendent. Tonight, the school board will vote on a contract agreement with Dr. Lisa Sales Adams. She previously worked in the district and is currently the superintendent of Eastern Carver County Schools. If she is approved, she expects to start at MPS February 5th. In less than an hour, the State Emblem Redesign Commission will meet again, talking about both the state flag and the new state emblem. Commissioners will look at the top six designs that could become the next state flag and potentially make a decision. If they don't land on a finalist tonight, there is a meeting scheduled for Friday. The commission can also modify the seal design tonight. That means certain colors and language could change. Of course, we'll be following along throughout the day and we'll bring you all of the updates. Meanwhile, check out this video of a rescue in Duluth. Firefighters braved 8-foot waves in Lake Superior to save a dog who escaped his leash and fell into the water. It happened by the aerial lift bridge last Thursday night. The responders went into the cold water in the dark wearing ice rescue suits. Once they had the dog, rescuers on an inflatable raft pulled them from the water. The dog recovered and was reunited with his owner.